when you take the samples, they're all averaged together right now. So other watersheds average, you know, with different zones, there's four samples taken in each zone, those are all averaged together, so it didn't exceed the MCO. Because of that.
John?
Well, I just wonder, is there's two factors that we're trying to communicate to us that it's not going to be running average water watersheds?
It's going to be a running annual average of each site with the watershed, each site. So if they have four sites, they can take the running annual average of the site on Elizabeth Warren, say, and the site by the Dan Church Town, and the site, you know, those are sites that I think they have.
So I have data, do you have any water supplies that meet the individual or any other criteria? Is it just basic treatment violation?
No, no, I tried to show you on those others. Even the filtration systems exceed once in a while. And the rule states that, you know, you take a running annual average, and it's not this particular quarter, maybe the water's just fine now, but let's say your running annual average happened to exceed, and you below the MCL, but your running annual average exceeded it, you would get a violation because of the last four quarters. So it's like Shelly said, it's not an acute, it's a chronic, more or less. It's an accumulation, is what it really is. It's not like you are here somewhere you're going to sit one.
Did I understand you to say that on the 2012, you said basic treatment was on?
They turned it on, yeah.
Is that being tested now?
Yes. Yes.
Do we have any idea what the protocol is?
Not right now. They have the whole quarter to take out the reading. So I haven't seen that. Yes, ma'am.
We're going to finish with the council first.
What does MCL stand for?
Could you wait until we...
Does anybody care what MCL stands for in this room?
There's a process.
No, it stands for what?
It's a maximum.
Level? Maximum what?
Mr. Gelson, I apologize, Mr. Gelson, the process that we went through, we asked, the council asked questions, and that is completed. The chair will recognize you, listen to any questions from the public. We're going to follow that council, and the chair will associate.
Mark, do you have a question?
The system that you showed, the ad for, and that in Glasgow, are those similar systems with reservoirs, or are they utilizing well water?
They're all surface water systems.
So any surface water system is subject to this type of contamination?
Right. The issue is with heavy precursors in water, and groundwater generally does not have very high.
Separate the sources out again.
Okay.
It'll be in the distribution system for the cage. So therefore, they feel that they, I don't know what the water guys can answer, but like, they feel that they know where they can sample to get a good representation of that source.
So,
they've been there before I started.
Okay. So they'll be the same sample?
No, no. Conversation. We had to do some testing.
Okay.
size of the aging pipe.
Do you have any more questions from the council? Okay, can I open it to the public? Leland?
If I understand it right, you're talking about averages, and so if you had another source added into this system, then your averages would be changed, or is that a wrong assumption?
Another source added in?
Yeah, like Silver Lake got tossed into this system. Would that change the averages that you're talking about that would come out because you've got, instead of the sources you've got now, now you've got another source which has a different pH and all that other stuff. So at the end, it would be the average would change at my tap.
I'll answer that. For John, it could make a difference if you have a source that is lower in TOC and doesn't have the precursors there. So you're not going to have the high disinfection byproducts in the distribution. So if the Duke is very unique in that you have three different sources and you have different waters blending, as you said, different pHs, different just different chemical properties that are treated slightly different, and when they blend in the distribution, they have the potential to, yes, increase, or if it's a source that doesn't have that potential to form disinfectant products, then it's going to be a lower, you're going to find lower DPPs in the distribution system. In most cases, most systems do not have to deal with three sources or three different treatment plants like Duke does. I can't, even the state of New York, New York City does not have three different sources.